Over the course of the term, we work well together as a group to respond to outcries for help from the community. We work with the mayor to provide funds for rental relief for those people impacted by COVID. And we responded to citizens who let us know about the impending gun shop, and we moved swiftly to create a zoning ordinance to prevent that. We responded as a group, as Councilor Grossman said, to our search for a new city clerk, and we're on the verge of hiring a new comptroller. But as a group, we've had plenty of controversy, as Councilor-elect Laredo referenced. For well more than half the term, the council and the community were concerned over what we are doing under the heading of zoning redesign. I know you've heard me talk about my Google alerts, but I can assure you that based on my Google alerts, lots of cities and towns and even states are deep in the middle of the same conversations with the same controversies we're having. I've reflected a lot on what's happened and why. There are at least two reasons. Our own council is divided, and our internal mechanisms for deliberation may have failed us. Which brings me to some important business that we should work on together. That's communication amongst us and communication with our residents. We have to get better at communication with each other and with citizens of Newton. When David retired, our newsletter stopped, and I know that our new city clerk has an interest in improving the communication. You can tell her that I said that, Cassidy. We have lots of councilor newsletters now that explain one side or another of many issues we deal with. I'd like to propose we think about a council newsletter that provides multiple ways of looking at certain problems. This would be too much for me to take on or for any one of us to take on, but I think we as a group, perhaps one member from each committee, could work on such a newsletter. I don't know if that's the right solution, but I plan to put this on the agenda for our first chair's meeting of the new term. Council unity has also been a topic I heard a lot about as I talked to all of you. I'm not naive, and none of you are, to think that we're all going to agree on everything all the time. That being said, what I pledge to do this term, and I hope that you will all join me, is to bring our problems to the table. In whatever committee they belong to, it serves no one to only talk to the public, either through public forums or social media or newsletters, without talking to each other here as a group. And I know it's been difficult because we haven't been together for 2 years, but we need to try that. Over the last several weeks, I've talked to most of you. I think this is a term when we have had many successes in the midst of a pandemic, when we were locked down in our homes for months on end. We solved many problems and we left many dangling. In the next term, I want to work on communication, as I just mentioned, and we will continue to work on transparency in government to learn how to run inclusive hybrid meetings with Councilor Gentile on the phone, and finish the docket tracking system and continue our work with our rules review. Along with continued work for our unfinished business this next term, I've already spoken briefly with the Law Department about our outdated city ordinances. Over the course of the term, I heard and I have read firsthand that our ordinances are out of date with our current practice across all the chapters of the ordinances. I want to initiate a process where we not only do the required 5-year recodification, but also review our ordinances chapter by chapter with the administration and update them as needed. I know this is a multi-year process. As you might imagine, my saying this, I would also love to see our ordinances online in hypertext link in a searchable way. Many, many communities have this. There's no reason why we shouldn't have it also. I will charge our committees with the task of communication and inclusivity. We must all work together towards inclusiveness and collaboration as a council, as a government, and as a community. I ask for your vote to lead us in the next term. Let's hope we won't be filled with external problems such as the ones we've had this term. We are a strong group, and we can do well for Newton together. And I thank you very much.
We have had some themes tonight that I'd like to touch on, and I'm not going to go too long. Councilor Grossman spoke of all that goes on behind the scenes in leadership in running this council. And I don't need to repeat the beautiful words that she spoke of how President Albright has has worked behind the scenes during a pandemic to keep things going. Every other week, we said to each other, what could happen next? I don't need to list all the things that happened in the past 2 years. It was something around the corner. Councilor Markowitz talked about being firmer and being a check to the mayor's office. He's absolutely right about that. And there were many times where we spoke our mind and had disagreements with the mayor, but you can bet the theme of working in a pandemic, running this city, a lot of what we needed to do was sit at the table and figure out for the first time in the history of this city, or at least since the Spanish pandemic, that we had to figure out what to do, how to pivot, how to get money, now how to spend money that's coming our way. So we worked more collaboratively with the mayor's office than I think typical councils have worked in the past because it was out of necessity. Councilor Laredo spoke of discourse, and you saw a theme throughout the night that social media is a little bit of an evil. Councilor Gentile spoke about it as well. I think that Matt Jefferson, even up to Brooke Lipset, didn't have social media. So it's fairly a new issue that we're dealing with. Yes, we made some mistakes, especially not just leadership, but others here, going out and getting emotional on social media and saying some things that may be in your heart, but aren't conducive to working together the next day on this council. This is a family. You know, we can fight, we can disagree, but we've got to come together for the best of this council, for the best of this city. And that is something that was lost a little bit in the past 2 years. Now, I'm going to say that the biggest culprit here is the pandemic. If anybody here can tell me that your nerve, you haven't been at the end of your nerves, that you haven't been more stressed out in your day-to-day jobs in your lives, that can bleed over to what we have to do as a council to debate, to disagree, to come together. The last 2 years have been difficult in that respect, and I think adding that to us not being in the room together, not being out for a drink after a meeting, you know, it was quite easy for us to become more divided than we have to. I was elected in 1996. This is my 11th term. I took a little time off. What I always felt till recently was that whatever we started with in legislation, what we're trying to get done, that it was something that everybody wasn't thrilled with, but we did something and we moved the needle forward. And on the national stage and in this council a little bit, it feels like it's become whoever's got the votes gets it done. That's something that I haven't been crazy about. I need people to walk into the middle of the room. I need the people that aren't happy with the way things are going to also walk into the middle of the room, to put down the angst and to start working together. That's what I see our charge should be for the next 2 terms, the next 2 years, the next term. I have so enjoyed working with Councilor Albright. We have had fun, we've laughed, we've disagreed. She'll tell you, I tell you when I think she's wrong. We've learned a lot. We've supported each other through a very difficult 2 years, but we do have a lot to be proud of. I've enjoyed serving all of you, and I'd like to be your vice president again for another 2 years. Thank you.